Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to learn the GW basic variables and constants.
The variables are named memory location. You know that the memory is RAM, and you can assume the variable as containers or boxes which can store something. These are used to store computational data and results during program execution. Computational mean calculations. The value of a variable may change during program execution, as vary means to change. If no value is assigned to any variable, then GW basic assumes that numeric variable is equals to 0 and string variable is equals to null. Numeric and string are the types of the variables which we are going to discuss later.
Variable has two types, numeric and string. Numeric variable stores only numbers. Numbers can be of three types. The first one are integers without any fractional part. The next is floating point numbers. These are fractional part numbers. And the third one are real numbers. The numbers having both integral and fractional part. And these number could be single precision or double precision. Let's see the examples of numeric variables. Marks, a container without any type declaration, so it's a real type numeric variable. Roll number person, integer type variable. Sum, exclamation mark, single precision variable. AVG hash, double precision variable. All arithmetic operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division can be applied to these numeric variables. Let's take an example from GW Basic. An integer type variable A stores 340. Again, an integer type variable B stores 985, and the capacity of both is 2 bytes. We take a larger variable with the capacity of 8 bytes, double precision variable, product hash, which can store their product. A string variable, a container which contain only the strings, anything written in the double quotes. How would you differentiate between string and numeric variable? String variables will have a dollar sign at the end of variable name. You can store anything in the double quotes, maybe with the decimal points, maybe with the mixed capital and small case letters, or with space, or just numbers, or a mixture of numbers and alphabets, or any special character, but within the double quotes, can be saved in the string variable.
Let's take an example of string variable. Two operations can be applied to string variables. The first one is concatenation, and the second one is comparison. For the concatenation operation, let's take a string variable A, which stores computer, and a string variable B, which stores lab. And when we apply a concatenation operation, you know that the plus sign represents concatenation for string variables. It will give us a result as a combined string. The next example is comparison operation. For this, we are going to take a variable name 1 and going to store a name Fahad in it. And for name 2, we are going to store Ahmed in it. These both are strings, the names. And I have applied a condition to print the greater name. We cannot find which name is greater because these have the same number of letters. But remember one thing, every letter has an ASCII code, and you have learned these ASCII codes in class 9. For capital A, it is 65, and for capital F, it is 70. It will check the first two letters of each name, and it will print the greatest one. You have learned variables. Now it's time for constants. It is a quantity whose value cannot be changed. These are stored in the variables. For example, any text written in the double quotes or any number. So from this, we have learned that constant is of two types, numeric and string. Numeric constants are the numbers. Numbers can be integers, floating point numbers, or real numbers. And these could be single precision or double precision. You have just seen this example in which we have stored two numeric constants in two numeric variables. And for their product, it is also saved in a numeric variable because it's also a number. For string constant, it is a sequence of alphanumeric characters. Alphanumeric means combination of alphabets and numbers enclosed in double quotation marks. The maximum length of a string constant is 255 characters. For example, Lahore 4900, I love Pakistan. All these are strings written in the double quotes. The containers or blocks of memory with their names as without type declaration character or exclamation, hash, or percent sign at the end of their names are called numeric variables. These numeric variables store only numbers of all kinds. These numbers are called numeric constants. On the other hand, the blocks of memory marked with a name or label having dollar sign at the end are called string variables. These can store only text written in the double quotation mark. And the text written in the double quotes are called string constant or simply a string.